FDG PET is a common imaging modality used in the evaluation of oncology patients. While being extremely sensitive to identifying sites of malignancy, FDG is very nonspecific. Many medical decisions are based on information gathered from the PET scan. It is therefore critical for the physician to be aware of the potential pitfalls. The use of FDG PET in oncology is based on the assumption that cancer cells have high metabolic rates and take up more glucose and FDG than the surrounding tissue. As the name implies, FDG is an analog of glucose and is used as a marker of glucose metabolism. It is taken up in tumor cells due to an overall increase in the number of glucose transporters and increased intracellular hexokinase levels, which both promote glycolysis. FDG is phosphorylated by hexokinase, and once FDG is phosphorylated, the structural changes prevent FDG from being further catabolized or transported back into the extracellular space. This process is called metabolic trapping and results in increased uptake of FDG within cancer cells. Unfortunately for the interpreting physicians, FDG is not a cancer-specific agent. Other types of metabolic activity may also show increased uptake. Sites of physiologic accumulation of FDG include organs which normally use glucose, including the brain, salivary glands, myocardium, the gastrointestinal system, and the urinary system. A variety of inflammatory processes can also show significant FDG uptake, sometimes leading to false positive findings. Activated inflammatory cells, such as neutrophils, have markedly increased glycolysis. The hexose monophosphate shunt, an alternative pathway to glycolysis, is stimulated with increases of 20 to 30 times that of baseline values, and this causes the high FDG uptake. Here are some examples. Tuberculosis is one of the oldest diseases to affect humans. It usually affects the lungs, but in 1/3 of cases, other organs are also involved, such as lymph nodes, the urinary system, the gastrointestinal system, the skeletal system, and the central nervous system. All of these areas of infection or inflammation will demonstrate intense uptake of FDG, and this will result in an incorrect diagnosis if this is not correlated with the patient's clinical history and a biopsy. Another example is radiation pneumonitis. Radiation pneumonitis is an inflammation of the lung tissue caused by radiation therapy to the chest. It typically occurs following high doses of external beam radiotherapy, for example in lung cancer, and appears between 1 to 3 months after radiation therapy. This can commonly lead to a misdiagnosis of infection. It is therefore important to elicit a history of radiation from the patient and to correlate the increased uptake with the CT findings to avoid missing a disease recurrence. On the other hand, tumors with low glycolytic activity, such as adenomas, carcinoid tumors, and low-grade lymphomas, are major causes of false negative findings. Another cause of false negative findings is tumor size. When lesions are smaller than 1 cm, they may not show high FDG uptake because of the 1 cm resolution of PET systems. Also, in diseases located near the physiologic uptake sites, such as the heart, the bladder, the kidney, and the liver, FDG PET should be complemented with other imaging modalities to minimize false negative findings. So please keep in mind that accumulation of FDG only indicates enhanced cellular metabolism and does not tell you anything about the nature of the cells, and that familiarity with these false positive and negative findings will help you interpret PET scans more accurately. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up.